How's it going, guys? Chuck here. And today we're gonna be taking a look at a little bit of an Ah Puch guide. Hello. So let's just get him up to level 3. I'm on level 20 while we're looking at that. Okay, here's his passive. Is it essentially any corpses that he puts on the ground, he can pick them up. And he gets health and mana back, and it decreases the cooldown on his number one and his number two ability. Okay? Easy enough. Get that last level there. His number two, or I'm sorry, his number one is Undead Surge. He throws two bodies out, and they stop where they land. And now you can see, like, I can walk over these corpses and pick them up with my passive. All I have to do is, walk over them, and it works. And essentially, that gives me health and mana back. As for the build on this character, I'm just gonna build up what I usually do and explain it as I throw some abilities out. Now, for the last item, you could go Bancroft's Talent and then Book of the Dead, or you could go Soul Reaver. Now, Soul Reaver is good if you need extra damage. But if you're already doing enough damage, then Book of the Dead is good if you're like getting killed in fights, and I'll show you why. So, we'll take Soul Reaver first to show you just how nasty this is. Now, I don't have any stacks yet from Book of Thoth. I should probably finish explaining the abilities. So, Undead Surge, like I said, throws two corpses. Boom. His number two, that area right there that you can see, that circle, if I put that over some corpses, then it makes them blow up, and that will do damage upon hitting something. So let's get these back right here. See, I pick up the corpses with my passive. My number one and my number two get a bit of a decrease in the amount of time before. See, I think it takes like 2 seconds off of the cooldown time for your number one and your number two. All right. For his number three, Fleeting Breath. He throws a corpse out just like this, and wherever it lands, it does damage in a small area that I'll show you in 1 second here. Okay, it does damage in this small area right here, and wherever it lands, it does damage over time to that god. See, it puts the icon over them, and it will continue to do damage over time to them. If they heal while that damage over time is happening to them, then lo and behold, they will be stunned if they get healed while that's happening. And number two here, I usually take Heavenly Wings. The purification beads, it could be either the beads or it could be oh, I can't look at it here. There we go. It's either beads or Aegis, depending on who's on the other team. Okay. So anyway, number one, number two, number three. Number four is his ultimate ability. It takes this giant area that you can see around me here. See, it's this giant square. I'll just put it here in the middle of this so you can see how big it is. Right? It starts from where you're standing, and each of those little guys that are flying across it right there, when they do damage, because I have built Gem of Isolation, they will be slowed by 25%? 25% for 2 seconds. So, ideally, you will have full stacks by the time that you're at that item. But even without any stacks at all, look, see, Book of Thoth has no stacks currently, and Soul Reaver's up. Now, here's the basic plan for how to deal with an enemy. You one, three, two. And that can happen to just about anybody that hasn't fully magical protection themselves up, right? See, I'll show you that again. See? Even if you don't get them with all three bodies, the damage over time from your number three should do them in. Now, as you can see right now, I don't have my Soul Reaver up. It has about 13 seconds left. And that's why I'm not getting that extra oomph. See, now Soul Reaver is a bit unnecessary of an item, right? Let's just see it one more time with the Soul Reaver on, because watching him get one shot is just so nice. See? One, two, th okay, sorry. 3, 2, 1. Right? The first ability that I throw automatically does its damage plus 10% extra because of Soul Reaver. And then when I blow up all three corpses, it just kills him. Right? Now let's see what happens when I only throw one corpse. How much damage just one corpse does here. Right? Minus the damage over time, of course. So there's one corpse. See, it only does like a third of his HP. Which is okay. He's gonna try and hurt me. That's okay. Oh shit, he ulted. I think I can take on Raw without even... Yeah, look at that. Psh. He is just an AI. He'll just come towards me. I was letting my Soul Reaver come back up. Okay, so let's see what number two with just the explosion does here, right? And pow! Look at that. Not his full hit point pool still. So it is important to hit with all three of the corpses. And see, even if you throw your number one and then your number two to blow them up, you can throw your number three after the fact and take them out pretty good. Alright, so I have 35 stacks. Now, let's see what happens with the with Book of the Dead. So let's say I don't want Soul Reaver. Let's say I took the Book of the Dead instead. Right, now just remember, choose a focus, Book of Thoth for the stacks, Rod of Tahuti for the magical power increase, Gem of Isolation to slow enemies that get hit by your abilities. Number one already does that, but that's mostly just for your ultimate. Like, if you can get that ultimate down and get that slowing effect on a huge area, that is a game changer for your team. Bancroft's Talon, it gives you more magical power and lifesteal, depending on how much health you have missing. And Book of the Dead is good for keeping up at a high amount of health. Now see, I can still one-shot him with my abilities. And now you can see my health bar down here, the green, there's like a little blue chunk in it now. That's because any lifesteal I have while at max health is automatically refunded into extra health for myself. And that never expires either. See, bonus health from lifestealing. I'll never lose his health until he hits me. Alright, so let's let him hit me some and see about how much damage I can do. Alright, so I let him ult me. So you see, he only just now busted through my health shield. So if I hit him, I'll be getting health back. And actually, he can't sustain this fight of auto attacks. I think this is a Raw that doesn't have any upgrades on him. Let me see now. 15 more stacks, and we'll see just how heavy this build at max build will hit for. See, the Soul Reaver is really just for if you have a tank that you're fighting against that is giving you a lot of trouble. I would actually kind of suggest Book of the Dead. So one more Raw kill is all I need for max stacks. See, now it doesn't look like that really does much of a difference, right? So if I... Okay, so here's how much damage I'm going to do at max stacks. Still doesn't kill him right off the bat. So, anyway, that is the build. You could substitute out Book of Thoth, but I don't think you should. And obviously, if you have a very tanky character on the other team, then you probably want that Soul Reaver anyway. This is how fast you can take out camps. Oh, shit. I have to get inside this little circle, I guess. Alright. Let's try that again, shall we? Inside the little circle... And I'm going to go bam, bam, bam. Look at that. This is the attack speed buff. Oh, it's the void. Oh, I see. Void buff. Very nice. Decreases their protections by 10. That sounds kind of shitty, honestly. But that's for a melee guy. Here's the magic buff, which I can't pick up currently. And I think that's, you know, a pretty good guide for Plush right here. Going into the lane with minions, obviously, you can lane clear pretty easily, as you can see. All you need to do is throw your abilities and then hit all three corpses. Essentially, what you're trying to do is get the front hit, and then you're trying to get like these bodies thrown back into the ranged guys, and then if you can hit all of these, then you can just blow up the whole line of minions. So let's see that again, right? Come on. Alright, so there's the minions. So we go 1, 2, and then we'll get all the bodies. I missed one of the bodies. It's okay. It's enough to kill minions. Alright, so that was my kind of Ah Puch guide. These are the items that I build. I don't actually usually take the Book of the Dead because there's usually a tank involved on the other team. So I will take that Soul Reaver. And that is purely for the added effect of, oh, hey, look at that. If you sell that book after you've maxed out your stacks, you still get to keep them. Well, anyway. Boom! One-shotted. It's complete. I mean, this adds way more damage because Book of Thoth right here, right? The stacks aside for, you gain mana per stack. I'd never have to worry about mana ever again after taking Book of Thoth, right? But also, it has this other effect. 3% of your mana is converted to magical power. Now, you're already stacking on 250 mana with the Shoes of Focus. And you're stacking on 100 more with Book of Thoth. And you're stacking on... I don't think you're stacking on any more of these items. So that Soul Reaver at the end for that extra 300 mana... You know, that's an extra... What? 30? That's an extra 30 magic power? I mean, holy shit, man. That's 130 magic power from one item, not to mention the 10% extra true damage that you do to their health pool. Because this is 10% before after mitigations. Mitigations are not applied, I believe, if it says true, right? True damage, yeah. See, 10% of their health is taken. Mitigations are not applied to that. So that is how disgusting that is. And it's really hard to actually hit an enemy with that. So you know what I think we should do? Is I think we should take this god into a game. Let's go into Clash, I guess. And see how this does. Oh, hey, Amon, he is online. I'll try and get my friend here in the group. All right. Let's see what kind of trouble we can get in here. We have a hunter and an assassin. I'm not sure if we really need to we kind of need a guardian, but I really sorry guys, I'm making a video. And we'll go with the necromancer skin, or should I just go with the diamond skin? Should I go with the diamond skin? No, let's go with the necromancer. Heck with it. And now let's see what the other team has. Now we have Anher here, which is a pretty good hunter. He'll be able to slow people down and give me a nice spot to throw my bodies at. Hun Bats will fear people. I will probably try to utilize his ultimate ability for getting some nice explosions. Let me see. I'm sorry that I'm cutting the music out here. I'm just checking to see if I am recording, and I am. And the enemy team doesn't seem to really be interested in locking in on what they've got. So I hope they're even picking anything. Because if not, then this is just wasted video. And I will have to, I'll have to delete it. look at that. Kukulkan, Kabrakan, and Neith. So they've got a guardian, a mage, and a hunter. Where they have a guardian, we have an assassin. Hopefully the extra damage output will help us. Kabrakan likes to put himself in a spot. I'm going to try and take advantage of that that placement that Kabrakan has to do where he can't move. And throw my bodies in and really take them out. But it's going to be... I have to be behind them to do that. And so... hopefully one of our teammates will buy wards. I don't see that happening because they usually don't. So we'll just see how that works out. We'll try and get, we probably won't get any one shots, because, you know, obviously the time that I'm recording, the one shots just won't be had. All right, so let's at least try to scope out the damage camp, make sure that the enemy isn't trying to take it over or anything. We'll have our number one ready. It only throws one corpse right now, which is unfortunate. The number one will get leveled up at first priority until the ultimate ability is available to level. I always level that first. But once my number one has three ranks, then I will start leveling up my number two for the explosion. Alright, let's see if we can't... Is there anybody in here? No? Okay. Alright, so get that shot, and... Come on, Hunbats. Let's go. Alright, so now let's get back into the action here. We got two buffs. They don't have any. So that's nice. We'll get some minions. Alright. So let's try and flank them. Oh. 666 on my gold. I'll be right back. I'm gonna get Book of Thoth as my second item, as I said before. I think because there is a Kabrakan on the enemy team, I will try to get Soul Reaver. But it may not go to six items. Who knows? Soul Reavers last just for that extra oomph. Okay, so let's try and do this thing where I come in from the side again. And... Did you enjoy that? No problem. Alright, no Kabrakan. You are so screwed! Oh my god, please. Please, Kabrakan, die. Oh, Kabrakan didn't die. Continue putting pressure on the Neith. Nah, Neith, you can't get away. You're screwed. Alright. Let's get in here, see if we can't get Kabrakan out. Alright. Automata! Alright, so I can get this next item here. I'm so out of mana, though. I had to go back. Alright, once Book of Thoth is up and running, I will be able to not have to worry about my mana ever again, honestly. Kabrakan. Alright. Alrighty. Come on, Coco Can. Nah, guys, you ain't getting in here. Oh. Okay, so I'll try and throw in my number one. I'm out of mana, guys. I really can't. Uh, Neith. Okay, so there we go. Tell my team I'm building stacks. They look like they know what's up. They're not obviously on a team together. I mean, they could be grouped together, but who knows? Alright, so let's get this jungle buff going. Get out of here. Get out of here. This is my house. No. Alright, so there we go. Now I'm throwing three corpses out when I hit my number one and my number three. Alright. Oh, Neith is so dead. Alright, let's try and flank around. Oh no, he's gonna die, he's gonna die, he's gonna die. No, he didn't die! Alright, let's get this up here. Neith, I know you're gonna try and jump away. Come on. Alrighty, so let's try and come in from the side here. Oh, screwed! Alright. I don't think so, Kabrakan. Alright, what's that T-screen look like? Top damage is me, someone else's top kills? I can live with that. Alrighty. So Coco Can, you're getting too comfortable. Alright, time for the one shots. Alrighty. Let's get the let's just get back in the action, shall we? Let's get my ultimate ready. Alright, so Kabrakan here. Yeah, that hurts, don't it, Kabrakan? Come on, Kabrakan. Nope, you're dead. Keep getting too close, Kabrakan. That's the problem. Alright. See if we can't, they're not checking over here. Like, ever. Good lord. Alright. I know I'm not talking a lot for a video. I apologize for that. Alright, I messed up. Bam! Alright, now that I've got my good items on board, I'm gonna get that Gem of Isolation going. Hell yeah. And maybe pick up a ward so I can put it down in a spot that I like to frequent. And that way, I don't get surprised. Hi, Larry. All right, they don't think I've gone over to the side. All right, they don't know where I went. Alright, so let's throw this out over here. There we go. And I think I might be behind them, yes. That was a good-ass gank. Alright. Let's get the tower here. Oh, Larry, this would be a bad time for you to mess me up. Oh my god. Bam, Neith. I apologize. All right. Let's get up my next item, shall we? Which is going to be Bancroft's Talon. And I want Heavenly Wings. I apologize. Your middle tower is under attack. All right, no. Negative. Enemy spotted. Cancel that. Cancel that. Looks like Neith wants to try and come around. Your middle tower is under attack. All right, Neith. Come on, Coco Can. No, dude, you don't understand. You are so dead. Oh, I got hit by that. Damn, I can't believe it. Which should I go last? Soul Reaver? I'm not gonna need Soul Reaver. I want Book of the Dead. Okay, so this is the day that I'm gonna take Book of the Dead, because I am getting... I mean, holy shit, look at that, I am so fed. That Kukul can is the only one that I gotta look out for, really. What is the... Yeah, see, Kukul can on their team is doing pretty well. What is his gold at? 12333? Yeah, he's technically doing better than me. Alright, let us not let them get too close. Negative. Alright guys, where's Neith? I think... I'm gonna continue to keep trying to come from the sides. Come on, Kabrakin. Let's go. Oh shit. No. Neith, you wanna go? No, Neith. Get out of here with that shit. I don't trust all this garbage. Negative. I don't think I'm gonna take that, There we go. Let's just get Book of the Dead up so I can get that extra health. There we go. Magic power, lifesteal, health. Hell yeah. And why not a potion of magical might? 14 and 2. Not doing too bad. Alright, we'll try and hit him from the side like usual. Kabrakin's gonna be over here somewhere, watch. Oh. Man, I'm having a good game. What is this stupid surrender shit going on here, damn it? All right. Nope, we're going to keep on pressing forward here and try and get them from the back. You're so dead, Kukulkan. What is that? Oh, hell no. Alright, let's just push on a little further here. Get out of here. No. Come on, Capricorn, let's go! Negative, dude, you wanna go? You want to go? Because I can go. Got too goddamn close. Killed me after he died. That's funny. It looks like it's only Cavrican, and I don't think he's going to do anything against us. 30 seconds left, though. Alright, I want to get, what kind of ritual do I want to get for my team? I want to get the revealing ritual to see what they're up to as soon as I come out of this really, really crappy. Actually, you know what I am going to get? No, I'm not going to get this. I'm going to get this guy right here. Alright, boom. Wards. Lots and lots of wards. Wow, guys, really? This is still a game. What the fuck is wrong with you? Get out of here with that surrender shit. No. Woof. Oh, get out of here, Neith. You cannot fuck with me. Alright, they're probably gonna come down into here at some point. I'm gonna try and take on the fire giant right now. All right. Come on, guys. No, Capricorn's got that blink. Nah, man, I know what you're up to. Nope, I really don't think so, guys. You know what I do think, though? That this game isn't over. Nah, Neith. Alright. All right, Coco Ken, you want to go? Alright, negative, guys. I don't think so. So let's come back around this way. Woof. Alright. So let's come around here. Let's get these minions because they're easy to take out. Alright, do they have a ward back here at all? No. They don't. An enemy has been slain. Sorry. That was a good ass game. That was a good ass game. Holy crap, that was a good ass game. Wow, I'm sorry I didn't say much during that. But okay, so there's an example of how to play Ah Puch. Oh yes. Let's get in the lobby. GG, well played them. Let's see how this goes. 18 kills, 4 deaths, 8 assists versus 8, 11, and 5 and 7. 14, 5 and 5, 10, 4 and 5. Yeah. I definitely feel like I did the best out of that on that in that game. How much player damage did I do? 88,144. You can take... No, I'm sorry. 50,684, right? Wow. Okay. I did more... I almost did more than any two players combined. You could take Lanchy here and Mav here and put them together and have more damage than me, but not by much. So, this is my favorite god, as you can see. We got some good one-shots. We got to see the build in action. We didn't see it with Soul Reaver, though. We saw it with Book of the Dead. And all of that crazy lifesteal that I have. I can take on the Fire Giant by myself. I don't really need my team for that once I'm into Bancroft's Talon. Book of the Dead was just unnecessary lifesteal. But man... I'm just reeling from that game. That was an amazing game. So I hope that you had fun. I hope that you enjoyed that game, because I certainly did. That's also why you never surrender. I had someone on my team try to put up surrender, what, twice? And then we won that game? Nah, man. Never surrender, because you can always pull it through if you're smart about your tactics, okay? Mav wants me to join their group. But I'm out of here for the night, so I will see you guys later. Have a good one.